Hi guys, good morning. Today is the day. So guys, today is the day for my schedule of going to DFA, which is Department of Foreign Affairs. I'm going today around 10 to 11 to SM Consolacion Cebu. So that's where I'm going. So before we start guys, if you are new to my channel, you can subscribe Manay Biday and you can click bell all, so every time we have new upload videos, you will be notified every time I have updated new videos, shorts and live. Okay, so our title today is application requirements of getting a Philippine passport. Okay, before I go, so I've been thinking about this, doing a review for all my requirements before I'm going to DFA. So they will give you a requirements for getting application and getting a passport, guys. Okay, so what I did was I have a friend of my niece. I asked her to book me online because it is really hard to get an online booking in to get an application to apply a to get a passport online, guys. So I have somebody get it for me for my schedule. So this is my schedule, is today September 11, 2024. Okay, so I already have gathered all the requirements that needed to apply a new Philippine passport. One of the requirements that they were asking is a photocopy. Well, actually it's our original PSA, okay, original photocopy of PSA, original copy of the PSA. So which is I have a birth certificate, live birth certificate, which is, yes, this is my original one. And also they will ask for copy for this. You have to have copy for this birth certificate from PSA. Okay, that's one of the requirements. Second, if you are married, they will ask a marriage contract, which is I have because I was married to an American, so doesn't matter. So anyway, so I was married, so I have an original photocopy of original PSA. Yes, marriage contract, so I have that. Okay, so they will ask for a Xerox copy for this. It's better you have a Xerox copy for this one. Okay, so you don't have to keep running around. Your schedule will be, so you don't have to keep coming back. So now, guys, also they will ask for a photocopy of one of your ID. Yes, I have that. So that's the third requirements for getting a new passport, Philippine passport. So I have that one. So second one, make sure that you have a receipt. Okay, you have a receipt from when you are paying online, when you're applying for application online. So I have to have a receipt, see, electronic receipt. It's it has to be A4 size. So this is, so I have the receipt for that. You have to have it cut, print out from wherever. If you have printer, you can just print it out yourself. And I have this one also, see, a copy of passport application form, which is when I was applying online. So I have this. It has to be A4 size. Okay, A4 size. I will tell you later, guys, how much it cost for me to pay my passport. to get a passport. So this is the third requirements, guys. Okay, the third fourth requirements. Okay, fourth requirements. You have to have this. Okay, don't forget, you have to have this. And if you want to photocopy with this one, so you can have one for yourself. Yes, you can. You can have a copy, and I have a copy for this too. Okay, so the second, the fifth one is, okay, I was asking if only your PSA birth certificate or marriage contract, if it's hard to see, make sure you have a local register, civil registrar of like this one. I have this birth certificate. No, this is my marriage contract, local marriage contract. Okay, I have this local marriage contract. This is original one. I got it from Mindanao because that's I got it here in the City Hall of Cebu because that's where I got married. I have Office of the City Civil Registrar. That's where you get a local civil marriage certificate. Okay, so this is what I have. This is an original one, and you can have a photocopy for this one. Okay, so make sure you have a photocopy for this one. So that is the 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the fifth requirements from the DFA to get a new passport, Philippine passport. Okay, you have to have a photocopy for this one, guys. Okay, make sure, because this is only needed if your marriage contract is hard to see or it can hardly read. Okay, so that's another thing is your birth certificate. If you can hardly read your birth certificate. Maurice, I wish my passport was around $25. Okay, I'll talk to you later. Let me finish this one. Okay, local birth certificate. Okay, I have this certificate of live birth from, I got this one from Mindanao because that's where I was born. Okay, okay, hold on. I got a phone call. Okay guys, sorry, let's proceed. I had a phone call. So let's proceed to my passport requirements. Okay, where we are right now is, like, I have a birth certificate, and this is my sixth requirements. My birth certificate local, okay, because PSA is different. Okay, PSA is authenticated, and this one is from the local registrar office. This is in Butuan in Mindanao, because that's where I was born. Wherever you was born, that's where you get a local birth certificate, registered birth certificate. Okay, so you need to have a copy for this local. You need to have a copy for this local birth certificate. Okay. If they need a copy for, because I'm sure they need a copy, they only take a copy for this one. Okay, I think you have to have this one. I don't know, I'm not sure, but either they're only gonna look at the comparison. They're only gonna compare it to the authenticated, which is PSA authenticated birth certificate, and if it match, because sometimes the PSA is not very clear. You can hardly read it. You can hardly see it. So this is how, that is part of the requirements, guys. Okay, so this is the sixth requirements, which is the sixth requirements. Okay, and then you have to have a copy for that, guys. Oh, actually that was a copy. Okay, this is, I already explained to you this, this is only a copy. So this one is the original of my marriage contract, the local civil registrar, which is different from PSA. Different from PSA, guys. PSA, marriage certificate, and this one is local registered birth certificate, okay? I made marriage contract, marriage certificate. So that is another requirement. So you have to have two, PSA marriage certificate and PSA local registered marriage certificate. So you have to have that one. And the seven requirements. And you have to have a copy of your ID. So ID, copy of your ID. You have to have either driver's license, government ID, okay? Driver's license, national ID, mine is voter's ID, so I have voter's ID here. But I also have, this one is voter's ID, and also have national ID, which is from the government. And which one here? They're both the same. I don't know where's my driver's license ID. So I guess I didn't. Oh, I have it. So this one here is my driver's license, copy of my driver's license ID. Okay. So I have three government ID. So either one of this you need one of this, you have to bring it with you. Because this is all I have. There's three government ID. So that's what I have, guys. And and I will tell you the cost, okay? But you also can ask the DFA. You can ask the online also how much it costs. But for me, it cost me... what's the receipt? Sorry, I'll tell you, okay? The receipt says... Actually, it's 1,000 passport fee is 990. $950. My passport fee is 950, and what's this? It's not clear for me. PRF, I don't know what is PRF, but PRF fee is 250. Total is 1, 9, 10, 11. So it's 1,200, guys. 1,200 pesos for passport, when you get a passport, okay? This is for when you pay the application passport to get a passport. It's 1,200 pesos, okay? So that's it, guys. That's it for today about the passport. And thank you. I hope that gives you an idea on how all the requirements, gather all the requirements to apply application to apply for a passport, Philippine passport. Okay, so thank you, guys. Bye. I'm babaying, guys. I'm babaying here on my video here. Okay, bye, guys.